Okay, good morning. I think there are around 13 people and others will join. And also, there may have some climate problems, weather problems, and some other problems as well. So ask them to, if they have actually a problem, then they can ask questions and I will give them, even I can give them a special lecture as well. And so we will start. I think yesterday we have discussed some introduction parts of this lecture and why this principles of product design is really important. Now I think you all are aware about that. And before starting a food processing industry or company, or when you are working as a production manager or even an executive, you need to have this knowledge. And there are some statistical parts. We will discuss those things as well. But before that, these fundamental things are very important. So I hope you all are familiar with the yesterday lecture and what we have discussed. There is general introduction and new product development procedure. Why do we need a new product development procedure? And what are the important factors in new product development and key functions? And I think you can remember there were two major methods. We have identified traditional methods and modern methods. So there are six or seven functions in traditional and around four major functions in modern one. And we have discussed genesis and screening method and also a market research. So objective of conducting market research. I think I'm pretty sure that you all know how to conduct market research and you are familiar with conducting online market research using online platforms. Okay. Vimukti, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then today we are going to discuss how to conduct it. There are several softwares and online applications are available. And I think Google is very familiar one and it is actually a basic one. So the people are conducting their surveys and research objectives. They are completing their research objectives by using this type of Google Forms like online platforms. But I am not ready to ask you to use this type of a basic softwares and applications, and there are well-recognized online applications are available to use for this type of surveys. Not only for surveys, we can use these things for many applications. I will show you, and you also can join with me to conduct this survey. And I will do some examples, and then you can go ahead. Type form is one of the very popular one, and there are Soho Survey and Survey Monkey. I think you may heard this one. It is very familiar one. And for most of the scientific applications, we use Survey Monkey like softwares. And Survey Planet, Sogo Survey. Like us, there are so many softwares and online applications are available. So you better to select the appropriate one based on your requirement. So today we will discuss Soho Survey and also Survey Monkey. I will do a brief introduction and how to log into these applications and how to prepare questions, and I'll give some examples about their importance and what are the options they have. Then you can go ahead with these guidelines and you can search more options as well. So I'm not going to explain all these things. Okay. Before that, the for your senior batches, I have explained these things. So today I am not ready to explain a Google form. So you can go ahead with these guidelines if you need. So I think, I hope, I suppose you all know these things. This is how to do it and how to send the link in Google survey. So I am not going to explain. Okay. Then we will discuss something important before conducting surveys. Before conducting a survey or market research, or even collecting data from by using these applications, or not only online but also peer interviews, the sampling is very important. How to select sampling? In your first year, you had some statistical lectures, so lectures regarding statistics. So you may heard these things, but I am sure you are not remember these things, because statistics are somewhat the people are not happy to study these things. So I'll give you a brief introduction regarding the stat we need to conduct such market surveys. So sampling plan is very important. What is the meaning of having sampling plan? To select, to prepare a frame, and there are several populations. So the population high. So we are going to create a frame scientifically and select some sample. In these days, the very familiar topic is PCR testing, how they are conducting. Now I think there are no sampling, but you may heard random PCR, how to conduct random PCR. They have sampling plan. They had sampling plan, and they follow these sampling plans and select peoples and get their sample. So that is actually an objective of having a sampling plan. So there are several sampling plans. I will discuss these things later. And probabilistic sampling plan are there, non-probabilistic sampling plans. And there are some new words, quantitative research, objective questionnaires. I will discuss all these things. Here you can see there are several sampling plans are available based on our requirement. But this is actually a very good sampling plan you all can apply. The name of the sampling plan is ISO 28591918, and this is actually old sampling plan, but still we are using this sampling plan to select, to get the samples. And here you can see three columns. First one is batch size. Second one you can see special inspection levels. And further, there are four categories from S1 to S4. And under general inspection level, again, there we have three columns. So basically, we use general inspection level for normal surveys. If we are conducting some special research and some special, when we have to select special inspection level, then only we have to go for this column. If not, for our surveys, our normal condition, we follow this general inspection level. Here also you can see 1, 2, and 3 levels. So you can select one inspection level out of these three, but basically we select the second inspection level. Okay. As an example, I will explain you. So we are going to conduct a market survey with 40 students. How many students we have in our faculty altogether? There are around 1,500, 5 batches. So 1,500 to 2,000. So the batch size is around this one, 1,200 to 3,200. So we have to select this one. this batch size. Then you can see some letters. So we are not going to select these things. So then this one. So the first level, you can see it is H. For second one, it is K and L. There are three letters. So then we have another page. Remember the word, remember the letters H, K and L. So we are going to select K. Then H, you can see sample size is 50. For K, sample size is 125. For L, sample size is 200. So at least you have to select 50, or maximum you have to select 200, but 125 is even also okay. H, K and L. So we are going to select K. Then the sample size is 125. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Therunane? Understood or re-explain?
Theruna, sir.
Okay. Okay, now you can select samples based on this ISO. This is actually international sample, international sampling plan. But, sorry, then you know how to select the sample. Then you are going to implement this survey in the Faculty of Technology. But you have to write, we have used ISO 28591-1989 e-sampling method. Also, we have select the general inspection level 2 for in selecting this type of sample. You have to, you should mention these things in your thesis or in your survey report or in your research report. Then others know how did you selected the sample. We should mention the name of the standard and general inspection. You have to mention whether it is a special inspection level or general inspection level, and moreover the inspection level, if it is a 2 or if it is a 1. Okay, I think it's clear. So these things are very important until you are surviving in this industry, or if you enter the academic staff, this is very, very important. Or an industrial level also, this is very important. Then the another very important thing is, then the very important thing is desired marginal error. You have this example. I'll give you some example for desired marginal error. It means, sometimes we can conduct a survey in the morning and maybe in the evening or afternoon. So and as an example, we have selected 10 people out of we have 28 in this batch, so I am going to select 10 people. Then I asked to complete the survey at 10 a.m. for those guys. Then they will continue the survey. And then again, I will ask them to continue the survey at 2 p.m. Then again, they will complete. Then finally, I will ask them to complete the survey at midnight, at 12, complete this survey. So, hope we can't get similar result, but the samples are similar, questionnaires are similar, but the only different thing is the time, and maybe there are some errors with the personalities. Sometimes I can select there are 18 people today lecture, so you 18 have different thinking patterns, so we have to avoid all these outliers. How to avoid these things? But basically, most of the researchers and most of the persons who are conducting service, they are not using this desired marginal error. So this is very important. You have to mention the desired marginal error value. Okay. This is the equation to calculate desired marginal error. DE equals, he said, square root of P, 1 minus P divided by N. Then there are two, the Z is a constant for, if it is a 95% confident level, it is, for 95, it is 1.96. For 90% confident level, it is this value. There are, you can see, it is a constant and it differs from the confident level. Then you can select it. And P is the sample proportion and the sample size. Okay, then here you can see example. I think you have gone through these things, so I just take this thing. A market survey conducted with a view to determine the preference of pineapple cake by participation of 100 people. Reveals that 78 people strongly like to have such a product in the market, while 5 respondents strongly dislike for the said product. Calculate the desired marginal error for acceptance rate at 95 confidence level. Then Z is, if it is a 95%, so you know Z is 1.96. But P means, what is P? Sample proportion. So how to calculate sample proportion? The acceptance rate. Ne? Out of 100, there are 78. So it means 0.78. And N is, so you can write these equations, write this equation and get the answer. So the desired marginal error value is 1.96 multiply by 0.041 and the value is 0.08. This is the desired marginal error and this is the acceptance rate. So there are, I am asking, calculate desired marginal error for acceptance rate. The value is 0.08. How to write it? The acceptance rate is 78%, and this should be there. There is very low here, but it is a value. So I think it's clear. If you have a survey game, may desired marginal error, you have to calculate. It means there is a small error because there are 100 people, but their thinking patterns are also totally different. And the time you have circulated the question is different. And the way they read and understand these things are also different. So their outcomes also different. So we have to calculate this desired marginal error. Questions? Okay. Then shall we move to the questionnaire and how to design it? But you can see, I am receiving several questionnaires daily for PhDs, for MPhils, for BSc research activities. Students are sending different questionnaires, but most of the questionnaires are taking much time to read. And we actually, what we are doing is, ඔගොල්ලෝ මොකද කරන්නේ questionnaire එකම කියවනවද නැත්? අපි undergraduate කාලේ අර we had a form to evaluate lecturers. Lectures evaluate kind of form. Then what we are doing is we tick to 5 for all questions. We need not to consider one by one. We know the 5 is very good. Then we tick all 5s for all questions. Questions, if we are having very big number of questions and the grammar, if it is a, if we can't read that one and the style of the questions, we have to consider these things before starting a survey. So hope you all will adhere to these guidelines before conducting an online survey. So questionnaire is the main research instrument and we call as study material scientifically. So basically, you all know this is a questionnaire, but in scientifically, we call it as a research instrument or a study material. And there are standard questions. What is the meaning of standardized questions? There are some questions how to standardize it. Normally, the scientific procedures before circulating the questionnaire, you have to do it with your friends or knowledgeable people. As an example, before starting your survey, you better to send your questionnaire with around 10 people. Then ask them to read this and give your comments. Sometimes, අපි ඔළුවේ තියෙන අයිඩියා එකක් මේකෙන් අහන්නේ මේ ප්‍රශ්නේ කියලා, but the others can't identify, others can't read it, others can't answer it properly. So therefore, standardizing means before starting the survey, you better to circulate it with your friends or even some people. You better to select the people they don't know about your research. So then only you can get the good output. That is called as standardization. To collect individual data about one or more specific topic, we use questionnaires, a kind of a written interview, and they can be carried different ways. You can call somebody and ask. You can use an online method and post it, or web-based methods are also available, and some face tracking softwares are available. We are not going to ask questions. We are not going to ask their responses, but there are some softwares, and we can display the question on the screen, and we monitor their face reactions and eye movements. Then we can get their outputs. Okay. So I need to explain these things because you all can develop such softwares as technology students. You all can develop applications, mobile applications to monitor the responses. Some are like, "Oh, camera, then we can take it. Call me, I will take it." So, Kabu Gam me can be happy. Moon, happy as soon as you know. But we, if he or she a friend of us, then we put the response as this is a very good. But we can get the actual value using the face tracking or eye tracking. So therefore, these things are very important. And types of questions and types of questionnaires. I think you have gone through these things, so I'll explain these things quickly. There are self-administered questionnaires and interviewer-administered questionnaires. Self-administered questionnaires means we prepare a questionnaire and circulate with a selected people. Then we can get their responses. But interview administrated means there are some face-to-face interviews, personal interviews, and mobile call interviews. And we can use some online teaching platforms as well for this one. Then we can ask questions and record their responses as we are conducting in your Viva. So there are two methods. And how to design a questionnaire? We should have clear objective before conducting the survey, and a smart question should be there. And sound literature survey should be conducted before initiating a questionnaire. Literature survey means the available data we have to study. How many studies have been conducted regarding this area? How they have conducted? What type of questions they have used? So these things should be referred. And population sample size, I will explain today. Understanding the target response, target respondent group or groups. So here also you can see 10-step procedure to follow. Types of questions. Again, there are two types of major questions, open-ended and closed-ended. Open-ended means yes or no questions. Then we just ask something and there are two options we have to select. First one is yes, second one is no. First one is true, second one is false. Likewise, there are pre-decided answers. We can't use our own answers. Actually, these are the, I think for in food processing, these things are very important. But closed-ended means this is the question and there are pre-decided answers. We just ask question and there are some responses we have given, and you have to select one or two out of the available given answer. So those things are closed-ended questions we use normally for quantitative data. Okay, and then the contingency questions, you have experience regarding these type of questions. First we ask, do you like to eat something, or do you like to consume this one, or like the yes or no, this is a open-ended one. Then if so, if you like, if so, likewise, then there are two or more questions. But all these questions are based on the initial one. So these type of questions we call as contingency questions. The entire questions are based on the first question. So if it is no, there are no replies. But sometimes you can ask the question likewise, do you like to eat banana crackers? If yes, what is your flavor? If no, we are going to ask further questions. Sometimes you can ask, if no, what is the reason? So likewise, these things are contingency questions. You have seen these examples. I am sure that these questions are very important. And multiple choice questions are, I think those are the most common questions you have in your A levels and even maybe in your university exams. We are using MCQs. But how to design MCQs? It is also again very important. Then api MCQ ekak ahala api ahano oyage vayasa obage vayasa kiyala. What is your age? From your batch. I think normally it's around maybe 22 or 23. Then one answer is 23. Second answer is 74. Third answer is 60. Then 12. So we can't use like the deviated answers. Okay? In MCQs, the objective of using MCQ is select the very correct answer out of these answers. So answer is there, closest answer is there. If it is a value is 2.94 as given here, there are some closest answers. 2.96 should be there. And some distractors. If we have two or three very closest answers, I think it's very good. And there should be some distractors. It is actually based on the application you are going to use. Okay. And rating questions are also available. I will explain. And Likert scale is very important. Likert scale we use in questionnaires. We use Likert scale. So this is very important. Founded by Likert in 1932. This is actually a type of selective questions. There are 3-point, 5-point, and 7-point Likert scale. Here you can see some example for Likert scale. Strongly disagree to strong agree. This is, there are 6 responses. So therefore, this is belongs to 6-point Likert scale. And out of these 6, you can see 3 are negative, 3 are positive. So equal intervals are there. They have maintained the equal intervals. Okay, you can see this is the center value. Again, okay, and here also you can see strongly disagree, disagree neutral, agree and strongly agree. Intervals are similar. Strongly disagree, agree. You have to maintain equal intervals in terms of Likert scale questions. And checklist type questions, I think these things are very common, so I need not to explain. And ranking, how to rank these things. Then you can ask some questions. Please rank your preference. You have some flavors, coffee, tea, wine. Likewise, there are some flavors. Then we ask somebody to rank from 1 to 4. Then you have to give 1 is the best, 5 is the bad. Likewise, the definitions we have to provide. And these are the tips in preparing questionnaires. The question should be simple, vocabulary, language. Sometimes you can see the question is with it is very very difficult to understand. They have used අපි කියනවා මොනවාද ඒ වගේ සමහර මේ ඉංග්‍රීසි පාවිච්චි කරනවා තේරෙන්නේ නැහැ. සමහරවිට සිංහලත් තේරෙන්නේ නැහැ. So the mother language, mother tongue is the best one to get the maximum very good output. And syntax we should be simple without subordinate clauses and without double negatives. Double negatives ඔයගොල්ලෝ දන්නවනේ you may have experience. නේ double negatives කියන්නේ අර මේ නැත්තේ නැත්නම් වගේ දෙයක් තියෙන if මේ මේ මේක උනේ නැත්තේ නැත්නම් කොහොමද අන්නේ වගේ double negatives should not be used. A logical flow should be there. We have to maintain the logic flow and avoid overlapping responses. Here you can see overlapping responses. Age categories 10 to 20. Again, there are two 20s. If somebody has 20 years in 20 age, then what he has to select? There are two responses. This is actually a one of the most common error in we can see in questionnaire. So where do you can use 10 to 19, 20 to 30. 29, 30, likewise, overlapping should not be there, and should not contain two questions in one. Double barrel questions should not contain two questions in one. So it should be a clear one. Questions must be concrete with respect to time and events. If you have designed this question here for 10 minutes, so you need not to use 100 questions. And events also very important. We select. They should not lead the respondent particular answers. And number of responses alternatives should be limited, as I mentioned earlier. Especially for MCQs. And adequate font sizes are important, and line spaces are important. Confidentiality of data and ethical problems are there. In current context, you have to use ethical. You have to before conducting any. Survey, you better to apply for ethical clearances. Ethical clearances, you can get it from our medical faculty, and there are some committees available in universities as well. So if it is a thing, sometimes you are going to ask some very personal questions by disturbing them, by disturbing others. As an example, you are going to ask their sex life and some very very, very, very. Sometimes you can ask some. As an example, you're going to select the amount of liquor they are taking, and what type of diseases they have. So they don't like to give their responses regarding these things. So you better to apply for ethical clearances and ask them that we are responsible in handling this type of data, and we have. Confidential is there. How to handle this data? ඔගොල්ලෝ දන්නවා දැන් ওই සමහර news වල දැකලා ඇති සමහර data හොරගම් කරන විදි තියෙනවානේ. Track කරන විදි තියෙනවා. So you have to avoid these things because we use very confidential data. මේක food වලට එච්චර වැදගත් වෙන්නේ නැහැ but sometimes as an example one company has given this questionnaire and collect their answers, then somebody, your friend is there, then you can ask your friend to forward these outcomes to you for your company to develop a competitive product. So you have to avoid these things. So basically we are conducting after collecting data, we process those data and we discard after getting decisions. That is a very good thing. Or if you are using this data further, then we have to add some password and like some confidential ways to apply. So this is actually very important. And pilot studies testing. Here I have mentioned how to standardize the questions. You have to apply these things. And other related documents for the survey, cover letter should be there. Information should be provided. Information sheet, I will share some information sheets with you and you also can get download from internet. And information sheet means you have to provide all the information regarding this study. What is the purpose? What is the objective? And when we are going to use data, how we are going to handle this data. And after the study, how we are going to discard this data, everything you have to provide along with the questionnaire. And consent form, it means the we have to get the get sign these consent forms from the respondent before before he or she participate the survey. We ask, do you like to sign this consent document? It's just like an agreement. This is actually a legal document. Then ඔයගොල්ලෝ වැක්සින් එක ගන්නකොට දන්නවා කලින් ලියුමක් ගන්නවා මේකෙන් මැරෙන්න පුළුවන් මැරුණොත් කැමතිද කියලා. Even some surgeries. So that is a type of consent. So then you have to get this consent form. We have to prepare this letter and get sign it from the respondent, the participant. And contact details should be provided with information sheet and consent form and also the questionnaire. And we should provide our the telephone number and also an email. Working telephone number should be there 24 hours. Somebody will call and ask some questions. So these things are very important in conducting a scientific survey. This is the assignment you have. Select a new product, design a questionnaire, but you just don't prepare just a questionnaire. Please apply these theories and select the target group, determine the sample size, and conduct a survey. And data analysis should be conducted and submit a report. I will share with you the assignment guidelines, but you don't need to conduct this one within this month. So I will give you 2 month time period, then you can do a very good. Your seniors also have conducted very good surveys, and I will give you some food products. Or you also, if you have good ideas, you also can use. But before that, please ask me, or please send me the list of the food products you are using. Or if not, I will share list to avoid overlapping. Then, please do not start the assignment today. So I'll give you some informations before that. Okay, do you have questions regarding this one? Then I'm going to share very important thing with you about sampling. Perhaps you all know sampling methods. Anyway, I'm not sure you are familiar with or not. So therefore, I'll give you a brief introduction about sampling methods. ඔගොල්ලෝ first year එකේ කරානේ sampling methods. සඳමාලි ඔගොල්ලෝ කරානේ අචිනි? Any answer? Start කිව්වම බයයිද? Divya, do you have experience with sampling plan? And how about Uttara? You know what is sampling plan, and can you give me an example? Waduge? What happened? Are you sleeping or?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then I'll go through this. I have very few slides here, so I will give you a brief introduction regarding the sampling plan. The sampling is actually a very important one, not only in conducting surveys but also in research activities as well. Sampling frame is there, sampling is there, and here you can see this example. This is a population, and we are going to extract some sample from this subpopulation, but this sample should represent this population. That is the thing we have to consider. And as I mentioned earlier, there are two types of sampling methods: probability sampling and non-probability sampling. There are two major methods. So we use probability sampling methods for quantitative data and non-probability sampling for qualitative data. So probability sampling means the meaning of this word is, it is we are going to randomly select the sample. Okay? There is a population. Faculty, there are around 1,500 students. We are going to select 10 people from this 1,500 randomly. But here, non-probabilistic is a systematic way. You can see the difference in between these two methods. Under probabilistic sampling, the important thing is every element has an equal chance to select. Every element has an equal chance to select because there is a probability to select. We have not pre-decided. We have not pre-decided the thing. Like as sometimes you have a chance to get COVID. We have not selected. We all have that chance to have COVID. Né? But there are some factors to consider, but just an example. So probability sampling means we all have a chance, equal chance. And each person in the group from which the sample will be selected has a known chance probability for being selected. And there are five methods. I'm going to discuss five methods. Simple random sampling, stratified sampling, cluster sampling, systematic and multi-stage sampling. When it comes to simple random sampling, this is the population you can see. There are three colors. And random sampling, we are going to select three out of these 60. Okay? But the very special thing is we never use prior information for sampling. Right? Okay. Previous information we never use in simple random sampling. But the probability is 1 over 16 here. Stratified sampling is another thing. Here there are some stratas. This is the population based on the prior information. Using prior information, we are going to select different, we are going to categorize the population into different stratas and then select samples from each strata. Again, every population, when we discuss about our faculty, there are five departments now. So basically, we had three departments. Né? Then we can divide students into three departments and then only we select the sample from each strata. Okay. What are the important factors in stratified sampling? We have stratas and then we are going to select samples from each stratas. Okay. Okay. When it comes to cluster sampling, here you can see cluster. Cluster means the population divided into clusters and they are randomly select. All the elements of the cluster are used for sampling. Clusters are identified age, sex, or geographical location. As an example, you can see if we are going to conduct a survey in an international level, with Asian countries, maybe Asian countries. So you have to get samples from all these countries. Then what you have to use is some cluster method. From the geographical location, we have to use the, we have to cluster the population into three groups. From Lanka, Kandukara Palat, Atharamadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyavadhiyav notes, or if not, based on the sex, females and males. Then there are around 20 million people here. Most probably there are 12 million ladies and 8 million as an example gents. So we can divide the population into two clusters and get the sample out of these two clusters. So, but here the very important thing is we use the prior information. අපි කලින් දේවල් දැනගෙන තමයි මේකේ cluster කරන්නේ. And again, we can see two subgroups, submethods in cluster sampling, single stage clusters and two stage cluster. In here, entire cluster is select randomly. Neither. Entire cluster ekama thorana. Samahala ada api hitanawa then FOT eke we have 1000 girls and 500 boys as an example. Then we are going to use the use all girls, right? It is under single stage cluster. All unit in cluster sample we use. Here you can see there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 clusters, but in the blue one we are going to select all blue as the example, all ladies. Two stage means we are going to select the clusters randomly and then randomly select cluster samples from the each cluster. So apde girls and boys la innawa api kelimma clusters thorna api kawuda kiyannathuwa eken thorla ganna. It means here you can see there are 5 clusters. Then when we select all blue colors, it means it is belongs to single stage cluster. And again we can use randomly select one out of these 5, one color out of these 5, then we randomly select this one, orange one, and we are getting samples from randomly, we are getting randomly samples from here, that is belongs to two stage cluster. Single එකේ කොට මෙතන අපි clusters පහ අපිට එකක් තෝරගන්න පුළුවන් සම්පූර්ණ cluster එකක්. ඒකට අපි කියනවා single stage cluster කියලා. And when it comes to two stage cluster, එතන මේ පහිනුත් අපි එකක් හෝ දෙකක් randomly තෝරගන්නවා. ඒ එකෙන් හෝ දෙකෙනුත් අපි samples randomly තෝරගන්නවා. That is belongs to two stage cluster. Okay? I think it's clear. And systematic clustering, there is a way to select sample using this equation. This is a basic equation, number of element in each groups, each similar groups and population size and sample size. In here we use here you can see basically we use first element select randomly and the other element select systematically. Here if it is this one, it's here you can see 4, then we select first one here, then the equal interval should be there. Ether palaweni ekak api thorna me equation ekak anuwa, sorry api me sequence ekak me interval ekak we select based on this equation. එතකොට අපි යන මේ ඔක්කොම පෙළියට තියලා අපි දන්න ඉන්ටර්වල් එක අපි හිතමු 5යි කියලා. දැන් අපි මෙතන අපිට එකෙන් පටන් ගන්නත් පුළුවන් දෙකෙන් පටන් ගන්නත් පුළුවන් but after that we have to maintain the interval. If it is 5, so 2 + 5 7, 7 + 5 12. Likewise you can select the sample. That is belongs to systematic clustering, but you select the first sample randomly. First one you select randomly and thereafter you have to use the you have to use this sequence. And multi-stage sample, I will use this. I am using this example. Here you can see Sri Javadhanapura. And multi-stage means we can use one or two methods together. We have discussed several methods. Out of these methods, we can use one or two methods together in selecting sample. And in our university, we have more than 6. Basically, we have 6 faculties, and all these faculties we have academic staff, non-academic staff, and students. Students are very important. That's why I use the red color. Then we can categorize all these academic staff into one cluster, then non-academic staff into one cluster or strata, and students into one. Then we can get samples. This is belongs to multi-stage multi-stage sampling. Here you can see cluster sampling is there, stratified sampling is there. There are different sampling methods we use together to get samples. This is a very good example for that one. Okay, I hope probability sampling is very clear. Okay, any questions? No questions. Good. Then non-probability sample. Non-probability sample is the basically you can see there is no probability. Ne? Non-probability kiyala thiyenona probability ekak naha. Okay. Basically, not use randomization. Might be bias. Ne? Bias enna puluwan because we never use probability here. And there are four methods we are going to discuss. Then convenient sample. Then here what happened? Also called as availability sample based on the readiness and availability at given time. Extremely prompt and complicated economical initial stage of survey research. We can use this one also. Thought readiness the ke velave thiyena vidiyata nu api hitala thoraganna. Right? Etra metra you can see the population, but in the sample there are no blue colors. It means the sample is actually not good, but he has used convenient sample based on his requirement. Convenient sample, no blue figures in this sample. Okay, etakota samanya me wage dewal ithin echcharama honda naha, but you can use these are the standard methods. And purposive samples are, it is also based on the selector's requirement. Okay, apita one ekkena api select karala ganno. Okay, and as an example, when we are organizing orientation program, we just select some students. We know those students are very good, they are not going to rank, they are junior batch. So we select, we know these students are very good, so we select this student or students purposefully, ne? Purposefully api select karna ekata api kiyana purposive sampling kiya. Third one is quota sampling is very clear. I think in university selection also under this one quota sampling. Etakota population ekai quota ekai we have to maintain the this proportion, ne? 50 male 50 female in the population. Here also 50 male 50 female, but when we select the gender, we can use different quotas. So it depends on some pre-selected standard. Etakota api as an example, we use CERT score. Ne? Based on the CERT score, we select people. Select as the representative sample from the population. Api hama district ekema quotas tiyena. Api ekata gannawa ne. This is belongs to quota sampling. Also, proportion of characteristics in sample should be same as population. Elements are selected until exact population of certain types of data is obtained or sufficient data in different categories. Actually, this is the quota sampling. එතකොට මේකයි මේකයි සමාන වෙනවා බොහෝ විට, but it's some special cases that is not. But here you can see 70 white, 30 black, but here 50-50 black and white. But in this one, the gender is equal. Okay, then it is depend on pre-selected stand. You can conduct your survey. In order to the quota sampling methods, it is based on Sri Lankan population. Then you have to mention the population is there. Now the 49% males and 51% females. So therefore, I am going to select 49% of students, male students, and 51% of female students. So you can, but you have to mention always the sampling method. And this is also again the last one, snowball sampling. You can see what happened to the snowball. After him, wetana kota over danno, hima ekathula 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 me hari kota loku wenawa. But And in SFT, Science for Technology subject, you had a question, I think, this year you had a question, what happened? A water bubble comes from ground to top of a fish tank. Malu tank ye ka. Oxygen bubble ka, katindang udra di mo kadoe ni kele kiyena. Ewa gimara, awol darna, hima bubble ya udra di nang pahal dira kota, tawa hima ikatula ikatula, meke lo kuwe no. That is the basic idea of snowball sampling. Then, you can select one and we use her friends and her recommendations. And then pyramid killa hala thiyena ogul wanne wage katha me, right? Then here, this is the researcher. Then he asks, he has select somebody and asks somebody to recommend two or three people. Then we are going to ask those guys to select their friends or their recommendation. This is belongs to snowball sampling. Here you can see further explanation. So I think it's clear. Okay, questions? No questions. Okay, here we have used, we have today we discussed about sampling and there were two major sampling methods, probabilistic and non-probabilistic, and you know what are the, what is the difference in between these two methods and probabilistic sampling. We have discussed five methods: simple, random, stratified, cluster, systematic, and multi-stage. Multi-stage means we can use a hybrid method using one or two methods together. Then when it comes to non-probability, there are four methods we have discussed: convenience, purposive sampling, quota sampling, and snowball. These things are very commonly used sampling methods in conducting research activities. Okay. Okay, and before that, we discuss some how to conduct surveys. So, do you have a lecture at 8:30?
No, sir.
Okay, then we have discussed these things as well. So, I think all these things are very clear and no complex things we have discussed today. Then, I think here you can see, if you have computers with you, then now you can join. Or if not, I think time has 8:30 now. The time is 8:30 now. So therefore, you can practice this one. So you can self-practice. This is actually a Survey Monkey. So when it comes to Survey Monkey, Google, you can type Survey Monkey. Survey Monkey here. And you can see Survey Monkey here. Then I have all registered that. Then I can go it directly. If not, you have to register. Here you can see I have already registered. Then if not, you can register here for free trial. Free trial and create a survey from here. Create a survey. Right? Then I have two examples here. I've already developed these things. Then there are some options. You have very good options here. Okay? Start from scratch, copy a past survey. By targeted responses, important questions. Likewise, there are. Different options you have to select. Okay. Actually, this is very, very easy one to develop your questionnaires. But to, nowadays, they are not. You can develop your questionnaire. Here I have. You can develop your questionnaire here, but they are not facilitated to collect our responses freely. Then if then we have to pay money and get this app nowadays. But previously, they had that opportunity to conduct. So, now you can use import questions. Then there are some suggestions. So it is very easy to develop. And you can use logo here. Then logo. You can drag a logo from somewhere. You can drag a logo. Can get any logo from here. This one. Okay. And we have some colors. Questions, title, you can select the color. Actually, there are some recommendations based on this logo color. If not, you can select these colors, apply colors, and you can see how it happens. And here, title, you can edit the title. Maybe a development of a new development rice based milk. Likewise, you can use any an alignment, center line or left line, and category, whether it is a community one, feedback one, concept, product, or this is actually a concept. Neither. Then save. Then you can see here. The topic and page title also you can use for first page, general, or maybe personal, or general, general, first one is general details. Okay, and page description also you can put here, and then enter question. Okay. What is your name, age, in general, under the general details you can. But here there is another option. From this one, here you can see question one and the same, this arrow, you can get, automatically you can get some questions. Contact details. What happened? Automatically it has given some detail. If we need the country, we can use, or if we do not need this one, we can remove it. Or we can type these things manually and save it. Okay. Personal. You can see our questionnaire. You can see the questionnaire here, logo, and topic, and under general details, personal details, it has given automatically. Likewise, you can add questions here, and there are different types of questions, multiple choice, checkbox, star rating, single text box, comment box, and ranking, and slider. So slider means like, leanness for the product. Neither for the product. Up to pull on slide again. Use kind of the left slide. Up to pull on. Up to the camera. See the product. Take it. එතකොට බිංදුව කියන්නේ කැමතිම නැත්තම් up to 100 ක අධික වැඩි අප 10 යූස් කරමු right side or center also you can use 5 then save here you can see now if you like the product very much you can drag this logo this one from here to here if no response from here if you don't like from here likewise we have very good options here so I think I'm not going to explain this further you can do trials and save it and here you can see the next button after complete this survey you can share it and automatically after conducting survey you can collect the details so you can change colors fonts footers layouts everything you can change as you wish to conduct okay here you can see one survey I have last night I have prepared these things logo and everything you can see occupation civil status I have used different options here then you also can do the second one is Soho survey just type Google Soho survey got it Soho survey then you can try yourself and I have already registered here and you also can register here and then we can see this screen here also you can create survey from here you can see this mark these are actually well recognized methods platform so you better to continue your surveys by using this type of methods okay survey name as I mentioned here maybe a development of rice based milk category name customer satisfaction survey education marketing business other actually this is a marketing survey you can create it I'll just type 1 2 3 and here also you have multiple choice drop down questions and prepare this one and so survey I think freely we can use then there are different softwares you can use I think I recommended to use Soho and SurveyMonkey in your industrial and academic applications but you better to find free trials are available but I was unfortunate to find because last night we had a power cut so you can search more options as you are aware and familiar with IT I think more than us so therefore I would like to ask to develop the assignment to conduct this assignment using this type of standard methods please don't use Google survey because all these people they use Google survey and it is actually not good and here we can use there are several options very good options and in terms of collecting data and analyzing these top softwares are very good so you better to use these things okay then I think you are familiar with these things and you have get something today you know you have get something new today and you add some new knowledge to your life and your maybe your career so please practice these things So as I always telling, please do not read. Try to remember books. Please understand what I am saying here. What I said, and for my subjects, and you can write some. You can write some. You better to use a one page A4, and note down some important things we have discussed today. Those things are very important And this time also you have online exam. Then if I have given some questions regarding introductions and definitions, you can type Google these things and copy and paste. So don't worry to do that. So I will never do that. So therefore, please go through these things. And you all have very good marks. I think I always give marks to you. And your seniors, you can ask them and know and get updates from them. They all have very good marks for my subjects. And actually, after pass out from the university also, you can remember something I have given to you. So that's how I wanted to do. Okay, thank you very much. And tomorrow, you don't have lectures because tomorrow is Sunday. You can enjoy the last day of the Sancharana Seemawala Antima Dawasa. Enjoy karanna. So you don't have like discussion. And yesterday I have shared the video link with you. But I will upload these things to the LMS. But these days, Mr. Madhushank is not there to create the folder. So therefore, I will share these things with you through email. All these things I have shared with Vimukti, and today lectures also I will share. And you can download the video if you are required to watch it further. And any questions? If you don't, I think if it is difficult to join with this time slot, please inform to your batch chief Vimukti, and I can arrange a different time slot. But I think these days evening is not good for us. The weather is not good. So morning time, we can arrange. Okay, thank you very much again. And please go through these applications and try these things. Have a nice day and be safe.